Hello guys, here's Tim CGI, and before this video or this little free course start, I will give a shout out to my first homepage. It's up now and the link will be down in the description. And here is just some work from me. So look around, get inspired maybe, and click on the learning tab. Here are all my courses available for now, and I will do soon some photography tutorials, so I'm really looking forward to this. You can contact me if you want, and a little bit about me. So that's for now, and I hope you will enjoy the video. Hello guys, and welcome to this a little bit longer breakdown, sort of a free course for you. I'm really excited, and thank you so much for hitting 1,000 subscribers. I would not be there without you, so a big thank you to the community and to my Patreons and to my supporters on CG Circuit. So I uploaded this little short, The Last Samurai. It's pretty short, but I like it. It's fully done in Houdini, sorry, and procedural, of course. So I think let's just dive into it. So let's review the samurai first. Let's get it started here. So, and the lights. So let's start with the samurai. The beginning is this simple base mesh here. And first let's get started with the base mesh. So it's pretty much only the base mesh. It's a transform and an output node in a little subnetwork. And from there I started to make this little tree here for the samurai. So the first line is just the base mesh again for a group, so I can assign a material if I want to. And let's get started with the samurai. So the second tree is the head or the mask of the samurai. So I just blasted a piece out here and I played a little bit with the topo build tool or node. With this node you can really get into modeling with a few cool tools here. So you can cut or split the mesh, you can move it, you can slice the edges, so like a loop. You can get a brush and move them with a brush. And here the last one is smooth, so you can smooth your mesh out. So then I go further and make a clip here. So you see before and after. So it deletes the little thing here on the zero axis. And then I mirror it back, give it a little smooth, a poly extrude. So I get a little bit of thickness here, and a subdivide, group delete from above, and make your group called head mask. And I ended up with this simple mask for the samurai. Let's get to the next tree. So this is the main tree, it's just the upper torso. I again blasted some pieces here out, cleaned this piece away, moved it a little bit and scaled it a little bit so it can fit the head better. Then the topo build node and just move around some edges, make a little bit fuses. So for example I fused this piece here together. Smooth node again, topo build, edit, edit, so I can get a little bit more detail. And then I clipped it again to get on the other side. So for the left tree here, I removed some pieces here, or only one thing, and then I built this little hedge shield with the turbo build node, so you can really model some pretty good stuff. It's not perfect, the node or the tool turbo build, but I really like it. Some edits here, some edits there, transformed it a little bit forward, dissolved some stuff, then the turbo build again, the clip, so I clipped this away here, and the mirror, and the smooth. So down here I created this little extra detail for the samurai hat or the helmet. So again, plastered one piece out here, this piece here. Then I started again with the turbo build and built this little horn here up. Transformed it, turbo build, mirrored, so clip and mirror to get kind of a simple symmetry modifier. Smoothed it a little bit here, so before and after. Poly extrude, subdivide, subdivide, and group delete, and created a new group, crown head. So head mask, this one, and crown head, the other one here, this one. So on the right tree is the shield. So again, poly extrude, subdivide, subdivide, and group delete. So the next tree, what's about it? Oh yeah, that's the helmet. So I blasted that out a little bit and get the poly extrude in here after the little symmetry modifier or tool and subdivided it. Whoops, no, don't make an edit. So then this is the base for the head, and this is, what is this? Oh, okay, let's have a look here. Okay, that's the first procedural tool I developed for this little clip, because to model these by hand it's pretty annoying and takes a bit time. And when we go to the last output here, to the material master here, we can see the samurai armor basically just have a lot of these plates here, all pretty good aligned, no intersections there, and I think it looks really cool, and you can take this to really make some cool details, for example this one too here. And I developed this tool, it's pretty simple in my opinion, so let's dive into it. So I draw the curve here on top, and then I moved the curve a little bit and tried stuff out, and that was not the best solution. So I came up with this a little bit more low poly piece of the helmet back shield. I extruded it out a little bit, and I blasted the backside away, and then I subdivided, and you will get these lines here. And I subdivided it again, and you will get more lines. And then you can just, with the dissolve node, you can create loops and dissolve the polygons, and you will just end up with these lines here. So let's just get rid of this, so you can see it better, and you will end up with these lines. Then I smoothed them a little bit out with a for each loop. So this is before and this is after the loop. And I transferred the normals from the geometry above down, and now you can see the normals pointing outwards. But for the transformation of the plates here, I need a different angle. So I coded some stuff here in VEX and moved the normals to the downside. So I just created a custom normal here and make some normalize and blending stuff with the lerp function, and it works pretty good. And now I clip this again because some normals are on the other side a little bit different, and the normal node or the transfer don't get it perfectly on each side, so I just clipped it. And then I will poly extrude it, but on the point normal and on the existing. And this is the point normal here, by the way. And then you just place a poly extrude node and they will get extruded along the normal. So then I just reversed these faces here. I extruded them all a little bit. Make a clip again, or a little simple symmetry modifier. Subdivide and subdivide to get it a little bit more smoother. And then here is the head shield, the basic or the base segment. Then the plates, and it looks like so now. And then here is the next little tool. So I wanted to give them a little bit of detail. So I just selected the outer edges with the group type to the edge and include by edges, enable and unshared edges. And you will get the outer selection of the edges. So then I dissolved the primitives inside of these plates and make a polypath node, and I will end up with a for each with a polywire, and I will get something like this. And the cool thing is, when I merge these together, I will get these outer details, and then with this outer details I can again make a group, merge them all together, and here we have it, the head with these little details, the front shield, the simple crown, the mask, and the back plate of the head. So I did make a master group here for lighting and shading development, and that's the first bigger tree. So now I think we will move down to the torso. Yes, cool. So I just clipped the head away, and I clipped basically the head and the rest of the body, and I will end up with this torso here. So then we will move down to the blast node, and I simply blasted here away a piece of the torso, extruded it a little bit, and played with turbo build. Again, symmetry tool, just with a clip and with a mirror. Turbo tool again and again. Then I think I extruded them a little bit out with the turbo build tool. Transformed it a little bit and make a poly split, so a loop in here. Again, some turbo build. I cut out the shoulders here. Make a poly extrude to give it a little bit of thickness here, so that's not bad. And let's get started with the next little tree. So I subdivided it 2 times. Then I basically make a selection here and deleted everything. So I will end up with these lines. Then I make a group with group by range. So I really like this node for procedural generations or for procedural R&D, because you can just select one of two and you can play with the offset or 103, 104, and so on. I blasted these and I just basically transformed them to centroid, centroid, centroid 0 and give it a uniform scale, and you will end up with all these points here. Let's get them enabled. So you will get these points. You can also get in here an what's the node called? Extract centroid? Yeah, this will make basically the same thing. So then I transformed the normals back, so you can see the normals will get transformed back from the original geometry here. And then I will get a little bit of normal scaling here, so I can scale the normals. I will push them outwards a little bit, so the position plus equals the normals, and then you can push your points along the normals. That's pretty simple but pretty cool. And then I modeled here a little button. So started with a circle, reversed it, poly extrude, and subdivided it, and I will get this little button. So I make a copy to points, and I will end up with these buttons here, or some extra detail. Color these in, and I will get the lines back from above. So a poly extrude and a subdivide will do the job, and I merge them together. So the buttons and the lines. And let's get further with the shoulder plate here. So that's pretty simple. I subdivided it, gave here a little bit of thickness, so to get some extra detail here. And then give it our own group and merge them together. So now to the top details here. Let's get to the tree and start from the beginning. So just the same clip modifier, so clip the head and the body. I blasted some stuff away here and built it a little bit top thing for the shoulder, so like a plate to protect the samurai. Then extrude, poly split to give some loops here, to get some hard edges here. So looks pretty good, and it's the topology is pretty clean, and this will be merged in the end. So then I blasted the extrude back and the extrude side group. So I will at the beginning I will get this one, but when I will blast the groups away, I will get these only the top topology of the shoulder. And then I dissolved again some stuff here, resampled it, gave it some normals here. I transformed the normals back, so with a simple attribute transfer, and change this to points and enable N for the normals. So I subdivided the line a little bit and extruded it again on the normals, so you can see it here. Extruded them and again blasted every third primitive. Make extrude here and another extrude on the extrude back group. Extrude back, yes. And just give it a little bit of inset. Reverse it. And normal, subdivide, normal, and the color, and whoops. You will get some extra detail here. So, the same thing again. Blasted array 6 primitive. Extruded it again on the normal. Reversed it. Color, mirror, subdivide, and you will get the bigger pieces. And another loop. Yay, cool. So, here are again some buttons. I plastered away this line here, the shoulder line, and blasted every fourth primitive away, and then I will get again with the transform and the blast node, I will again get this little points here, which I can use then to get the normals back from the topology above. So this is the topology above, and I transform the normals, scaled them or moved them a little bit outwards with the at p plus equals at n function and the slider. And then I, whoops, let's disable the normals. And then I will place the buttons here. So again, the buttons and a mirror. And of course, the plate here. Subdivide symmetry and color and join them all together. And you will get something like this. So pretty good topology. The poly count is maybe for some other kind of stuff, for animation or so on, a little bit too high, but I did it like this. So then I merged all these together, and let's get the normals in here. And this is the shoulder part of the samurai soldier. And I merged it, of course, with the head. So let's just get it here, a merge, and have a look. So this is the head part and the shoulder part merged together. Let's delete this. And let's go on with the next. So the chest. So just again clipped the upper torso part now, and I think I deleted the arms. Yeah, deleted the arms and some other stuff. In chest, front, under, right. Nice naming, Tim. So let's get started here. Basically transformed it a little bit outwards so it don't intersect with the given topology from above. Make some little changes here to the topology, mirrored it again, smoothed it, subdivide, subdivide, and here comes the loop. So this is basically the same loop. So let's compute here the normals to the points. Here it's basically the dissolving of the lines again. Here, smoothed them a little bit inside of a loop, transferred the normals back. Let's have a look from the top. Yeah, pretty good. And here again, a little bit of vex for the alignment. And here again is the poly extrude for the point normal. And you will get something like this. Reverse the other pieces, subdivided, mirrored it, and you will get the plates here from the torso. Then here's again the other loop with this dissolving of the outer edges or the unshared edges, and just did a simple poly wire, and you will get this little detail here. So this is basically all the same loop. I will just when free crew here. So let's get the upper chest. It's again just some topology changes. Subdivided it and subdivided here again for the plates. Transformed the normals. And it works pretty well. Poly extrude at a point normal. Transform the normals back, reverse them. And you will get the front piece. So let's have a look on this. You will get a front piece with the base piece inside of here. And here again, dissolve them and get the outer details, the detail of the little lines here. This whole setup again for the back part. So just created the plates again, smoothed them, subdivided them, and the base plate. Here's again the detail lines. This is the next loop. And now let's have a look. Visualize all. This is the plate or the torso armor piece. Looks pretty good. So the next loop was here. So this is the other part. This is the back under part. So just again for the base plate, smoothed it and subdivided it, and here for the plate pieces. Just again dissolve polypath and so on, created the angle here. Clipped it, symmetry. Don't know what that is. So transfer the normals back, reverse the normals. Mirror, subdivide, subdivide, and this are the detail plates. So then the detail lines, again, just the same stuff. Merge them all together to get this back piece. And then again all together to get the whole torso piece. Pretty cool, looks pretty good. And let's get further here. So this is the shoulder. Just some stuff here, modeled a little bit here, transformed it, poly extrude to get the base plate, subdivided it to get the lines for the shoulder, to get something like this, transformed the normals from the original topology back, and so on and so on, and you will get, let's get a null here. To have a look, you will get the shoulder pieces, the detailed plates, and the detailed outer lines. And you will get the shoulder pieces, or the shoulder armor piece. So, what's the next tree? In arm. Cool. So, the arm, pretty much the same thing. Topology blasted, I blasted the backside away with the blast node. So right here, I think, yes. Played a little bit with turbo build. Subdivided it, and again the loop to get the plates and the normals back. And you will get the two arm pieces. So this again with the hand. So with the hand it's, I think, a little bit, it's pretty much the same setup. So again the hand piece. I did make here a little bit other approach, so I don't use the whole loop. So I just used some pieces, because with the whole loop you will get pretty much the same stuff out of there, but I like the more irregular approach, so I get maybe one armor plate that goes all the way through, but some armor plates are maybe only the middle, some are in the middle and don't have the right end and the right beginning, and I really like this overlapping in the end here, so it looks pretty cool. So that's the arm. Oh, the hand, sorry. And I merge them all together. So let's have a look. So the head, the torso, the chest plate, the back plate, shoulders, arm, and the hand plates. So this the next one, the lower body. Show chest plate again, a little bit with turbo build. And it's the same setup with some tweaks for the back plates. Yes, these are the back plates. Then we will get nice ass here. So let's just. These are the front plates. So again, some smoothing, subdividing, dissolve the edges, get the angle, get the blades out, merged all together, and you will get this kind of blades on the front from the samurai. And I will end up with the out lower body front. Cool. Let's go to the next loop. This is, I think it's the, yeah, this is the middle one. So the middle protection for the samurai. Again, the same setup. And this is the last one, the back setup. This is a little, yeah, a little bit out of detail. I modeled for the body. Nothing special, just clipped here and clipped here, blasted it again. Then with the turbo build, I fixed this inset here on the back, transformed it a little bit, extrude and subdivide. So this is the last loop. These are the legs, so the upper part of the legs. Just again, smooth, poly extrude, subdivide and subdivide. And here again, the plates. And you will get something like this. For the lower part of the legs. And in the end, some simple shoes. So this is basically a polyfill here, VDB, and yeah, smoothed it a little bit because I didn't need here the detail. So, and this all merged together, I will get this samurai. Yay, cool. So this is just a grouping setup for the materials. So I will get the detail plates master group with all the plates, the detail outer plate lines master for all the lines, the base plate master, the master body, and out other. So I merged them all together and I created some materials here. Oh, the spear. Yeah, the spear is nothing special. Let's dive inside here. Let's get a little tutorial how to model a simple spear. So, use a tube, transform it, poly split, poly extrude, then make some edits here, poly extrude, poly extrude, poly split, poly extrude. This is on the back side. Poly extrude, poly extrude, poly extrude, and yeah, you will get this little spear here. Edit some poly extrude outwards, normals, recompute, poly split, poly extrude to get here a detail. And I transform it a little bit to get it a little bit thinner. And you will really get here a really, really basic spear. So I left the display flag right here. Then I moved it to the arm to get something like this. So that's for the samurai. And here are some vellum colliders. So out vellum collider for the samurai and for the spear. So let's get out of here finally. And let's get to the vellum setup. So let's dive inside. Let's look first at the collider geometry. So here's just the samurai, so I merged in the out vellum collider. I created the null over here and just make a VDB and convert VDB to get a little bit of detail here, and on the back merge them together with a box. And now let's create a simple coat here, or a cape. So clip, mirror, remesh, transform. I copied it 3 times because I wanted maybe a multi-layer coat, and I really like how it performed in the simulation. So for each, plastered the outer edges, make a convert line, and just make attribute randomize to the normal, make a attribute randomize to the p scale. So ptnum inside random fit parameter for a multiplier of the global scale, and bind it out as a float here, single float to the p scale. And you will get something like this. So I booleaned them away to get some details here, some cutouts, and remeshed it. And I did this 3 times in the loop. So then I manually get the pinpoints here for the vellum cloth. So vellum cloth, just get the pinpoints here. Cloth, I tweaked a little bit of the settings. Vellum solver with a little bit of wind, so nothing special. And then we will have this file here. I cache it out and you will get something like this. So let's have a look. Falling down first onto the samurai and the box. And the wind will drag it away, and I really like the look of the little coat or cape. Yeah. So that's the setup, the simple setup for the cape. So let's move on to the simple spear setup. I just drew one line here, copy it, make some details here again, pinned it again, the same vellum solver with the same setup, and I will end with something like this. I merged them both together. And I will get this little flags here, or the decorated badges or bandages for the spears, and I will get here the little cape for the samurai. So then again, make material here, and yeah, that's the cape and the little detail on top of here. So place the transform here for the global transform. The stand, it's pretty much a box, so nothing special about that. And you will get something like this. So, then what I did here. Yeah, then let's move on to the geometry here. That's a pretty simple setup. So, a box. Make a density volume out of it. Just some noise in here. Convert it back. Again, some noise. Convert it back. Bend it 180 degrees. Mirrored it. Merged it together. Transformed it. Packed it for Redshift as an instance. Transformed it 2 times. And that's it for the environment. So that's the environment for the samurai. Then I experimented a little bit with the lighting and cameras here. So I did one side light here, top light, a rim light, and a fill light from the side to get a pretty good lighting setup for the samurai. And one big light for the god rays getting through this abstract environment here. So then the material setup, just nothing special. A gold material for the lines. This is the detail plate material, a little bit of custom stuff with noises, and make a leather material. Then the cape, little bit of noise, bump. The spear, the crown is golden, the background, and the box. And the volume shader I didn't need. So, then the out, just RobNet to save it out. And I like the setup because you can get pretty nice details out of this. So this is one type of shot here. So let's get it running. So it's pretty detailed. You can go further, of course. And this is the main camera here. So I did a long camera track to get the movement I want to. And you will get something like this in the end. So then I rendered this stuff out here with this camera movement here. So I rendered, I think, from here. And then I rotated the environment a little bit. And that's pretty cool. So then I rendered all out with some passes. And I jumped into Resolve. So let's get Resolve running here. Black magic design, come on. So the last samurai. Basically, just imported it, added it a little bit, added some fusion stuff, and then I exported it. So let's have a look to the final clip again. Let's get deja vu here. Let's get a clip in here. And that's the final simple clip. I liked it how it turned out. all done in Houdini. Of course, the last color corrections and compositing in Fusion and in Resolve. So thank you again, guys, for 1,000 subscribers. And I will see you in the next course, in the next tutorial. Thanks for my Patreon supporting me, and have a nice day, guys.